Disaster movies love to scare us, and as moviegoers, we love to be scared. But sometimes, the scariest things of all are the ones that we can't see. The things that we can't touch or feel. The things that are unknown. It's things like radiation, infectious disease, or even a faraway comet hurtling at the Earth. Hey guys, I'm Aaron, and today we're gonna find out if disaster movies are as realistic as they think they are. We're going to be talking to an expert on nuclear and biological disasters, and he's going to review three films that deal with precisely these kinds of insane events.
My name is Chaim Rafalowski. I'm the disaster management coordinator of Magen David Adom in Israel. Throughout my years, I've been dealing with CBRN, with chemical, biological, radiological, and nuclear accidents.
First up is a 2016 South Korean film called Pandora. It's about the explosion of a nuclear power plant caused by an earthquake, which spreads fear and chaos to a small town. It's even got the rats freaking out.
Is this because of the leak from the power plant that the rats are jumping into the water?
You know, you see this in movies a lot where the animals will react before the humans do. And I kind of always wanted to ask someone, is this even real?
What we know is that since some animals have a hearing spectrum, which is different from the human beings, specifically cats and dogs might hear some sounds that are not heard by human beings coming from the earth. Very few seconds before the earthquake. What they hear is a sound that they are not used to. And this is why they behave differently, because they are reacting to a change in the environment. There is no research I'm aware of that we can pinpoint a specific animal that will behave in a specific way enough time before an earthquake. So rats jumping into the river, that's Hollywood, I guess. Yeah, a hell of a earthquake, I have to say. It was a very strong earthquake. First of all, it's important to say that no one in the video is doing the right thing during an earthquake. Duck and cover. Duck and cover. Duck and cover. Find a place where the chances that the debris falling on top of you will hit you under the strongest furniture you can find, and cover your head and hold tight until the shake is over. That's an important message. I would expect Hollywood to show that, because people tend to do what they see on movies. Okay, I will start with the medical part. Very dramatic, very, very untrue. You have a very clear sequence, and you don't decontaminate people inside your hospital, because all the contaminated water is there and you are stepping into it. So you are building a source of additional contamination inside your hospital. So you decontaminate outside with good drainage of the water. You measure people, especially in radiation, for the level of residual radiation on their body. And after you are sure that they are clean, you get them into treatment.
Next up is a 2019 HBO miniseries, Chernobyl. For those who missed the plot, or the historical event for that matter, this series revolves around the 1986 nuclear power plant explosion and its aftermath.
LHC disabled, global control activated.
What did you do?
I did what you said, I switched.
Look at it! I don't understand. Amateurs, you stalled the reactor. How the f*** did you get this job? Comrade the Outlaw.
You're going to tell me that you did everything right again, you incompetent asshole.
I apologize for this unsatisfactory result.
What are you doing?
We have to shut all the way down.
No.
We could be in a Xenon pit. We have to shut down and wait 24 hours.
No, we're doing the test tonight. Raise power to 700.
We can't raise the power from here. The rules.
Don't talk to me about rules.
If we fall from 80%...
No, we fell from 50% of power.
From 50%, it's even
the
worse.
Rules don't say 50. There is no rule.
Comrade the Adlov, I apologize, but what you're saying makes no sense.
Raise the power.
No. I won't do it. It isn't safe.
A very brave man. This is one of the phenomena that during the investigations of air accidents has been put forward as a cause for many accidents. And that's the idea that the person who is the senior person in the cockpit or in any incident does not listen to others, especially when it comes to serious concerns. And there is a tool called cockpit resource management where pilots are trained to listen one to the other, especially when it comes to concerns on safety. It means that in our business, especially in the rescue business, you first make sure that you're doing things in a safe way that will not harm your personnel and will not cause further damage to the people involved.
Next up is a third film, the 2021 Netflix movie Don't Look Up, where two astronomers try to use the power of the media to warn mankind of an Earth killer comet.
Madam President, approximately 36 hours ago, PhD candidate Kate DiBiaschi here discovered a very large comet.
Oh, yeah. Good for you.
A comet between 5 to 10 kilometers across that we estimate came from the Oort cloud.
Wow.
Which is the outermost part of the solar system. And using Gauss's method of orbital determination and the average astrometric uncertainty of 0.04 arc seconds, we then asked...
Whoa, what the hell
I'm
is
so
what?
Bored. Just tell us what it is. Seriously, stop.
That's a real challenge. And it is to translate science into some real-world words that people will understand. And especially when you're bringing the bad news, people try to deny bad news. And if you use a language that is highly scientific, it's very easy for them to say, okay, I don't get it. I don't understand it. So it's not for real.
It's headed directly at Earth, and it really likely will hit.
This sounds very, very exciting. Exploding stars, like stars actually explode. So how big is this thing? Could it like destroy someone's house? Is that possible?
Well, Comet DiBiaschi, which is what it will officially be named, is somewhere.
Congratulations. What an honor, yeah, right, congratulations.
It's somewhere between 6 and 9 kilometers across, so.
It's big.
It would damage the entire planet, not just a house. No.
The entire planet. Okay, well, as it's damaging, will it hit this one house in particular that's right on the coast of New Jersey? It's my ex-wife's house. I need it to be hit. Can we make that happen?
You and Shelley have a great relationship. No, you stop.
Listen, in all
fairness... You need to stop.
I will, but in all fairness, I actually paid for the house.
I'm so sorry.
Are we not being clear? We're trying to tell you that the entire planet is about to be destroyed.
Morning shows are supposed to be light. They're supposed to be fun. They don't want news about, the world is going to be destroyed. So, of course, they will make fun out of anything, try to lighten up the atmosphere. They are not built for such kind of news. Let's take climate change. Climate change has been on the table for the scientists for decades. The only moment it started moving ahead and countries really committing to climate change is when it hit the media. In disaster management, we call it the CNN effect. If you have a crisis and you are hitting the headlines of CNN, you will be able to do something. Otherwise, you are dealing with a neglected disaster.
So what's your bottom line after watching these three films?
We need to be very clear about our duty to convey the message to the people in a way they understand it. And for us as experts to realize that if we do not convey the message to people in an understandable way, they will not follow the advice. And it is our role as the experts to gain the respect of the general public and to gain not just the respect, but also their attitude of following our advice. Trust is something that we must create and work daily to maintain.
All right, well, here we are. I hope you guys were blown away by this video, and don't forget to like and subscribe to the IFRC channel, and we'll see you next time.